In this video, you will learn how to create a menu in Top Panel. At the end, you should be able to create this menu. I designed a very simple icon with Inkscape and put it in the extension folder. Import main to have access to the panel. Import SC to have icon. Import GObject to register GObject class. Import GIO to load the icon file. Import panel menu to create panel button with menu. Import pop-up menu to create menu item. Get current extension as me. Create a global variable that can hold the panel menu. We can register our class with GObject like this. Now create a class like this. This class should extend panelMenu.button. To initiate the parent class, we use super. I'll explain about this parameter later. Create icon by SC. I want to use it as icon in top panel. You can use the icon from your system. For example, I'm using symbolic icon here. Because we want to have the correct icon size in top panel, we should use this class. Now we can add the icon to the top panel button. On enable, we can add the button to the panel like this. The first parameter is role, and the last one is index number. On disable, you can remove it from panel with this row. As you can see, we have symbolic icon in top panel. You can also use your own icon with GIcon. To load your icon file, you can use GIO like this. As you can see, we have the icon.svg in top panel. Just to remind you, never use a string like this without using getText. This is just for the sake of simplicity in this tutorial. We have menu inside our panel button, and you can add the item to the menu like this. As you can see, the item is in the menu, and you can click on it. You can add another element to the pop-up menu item with Add Child. As you can see, we have our label after the text. The text itself is label. For click event, use activate. Now, by clicking on the item, we have our log. You can add separator as menu item. If you don't have item before or after it, the separator item won't show up. Here, I'm adding another item that user cannot click on it. As you can see, we have the separator and disabled item in our menu. You can also monitor opening and closing the menu like this. As you can see, by opening and closing the menu, I will be notified. To create submenu item, use pop-up submenu menu item like this. You can add it just like other items. We have menu inside submenu. We can use it to add items. Now we have two items inside the submenu. You can also use index number if you don't find the default order. As you can see, the second item is the first. You can also create a section with pop-up menu section. Use Add Child inside Actor to add items to it. At the end, you can add it just like normal item by add menu item. Now the section is showing up in our menu. To add item with icon, you can use pop-up image menu item. You can use icon name or GIO icon for this parameter. Here I use icon name. at the item just like a normal item. As you can see, the item with icon and text is here. If you use 1 instead of 0 here, the menu will be opened in the other direction.